Good evening. We're back with yet another edition of News Night. And the topic of discussion is inevitable. Sadhvi Pragya Thakur, the Bhopal candidate of the BJP, had made that statement which invited outrage from not just the opposition parties, but also the entire country. Things got so bad at one point, the BJP had to immediately retract the statement. Disciplinary inquiries and committees were initiated. And today what we saw was the highest leadership in the BJP, including Amit Shah. And now the Prime Minister in an interview saying that she might have apologized, which, by the way, was not a public apology. She had sent the apology to the MP chief of the BJP. I and many others do not constitute that as a public apology. Having said that, the Prime Minister said she might have apologized, but he would never, ever forgive her for what she said. He also said that all those people making such comments on either Mahatma Gandhi or Nathuram Godse will have to think 10 times before they do so. Now, what exactly is the message from the BJP? To my mind, the BJP is giving out mixed signals, mixed feelings on this. We also saw that today in the press conference that Amit Shah briefed the press and the Prime Minister attended. When asked about Sadhvi Pragya Thakur's comments on Mahatma Gandhi and Nathuram Godse, and when the journalist asked Amit Shah whether or not that would be tolerated, Amit Shah made two things very clear. One, that they would not take back the candidature of Sadhvi Pragya Thakur, that it was their way of satyagraha against what he called was the fabrication or the fabricated saffron terror theory. On the other, we have the Prime Minister's statement which slams Pragya Thakur no end. So what exactly is the message BJP is trying to portray as far as Pragya Thakur and others who've joined the bandwagon of insulting Mahatma Gandhi? Remember today, it wasn't just Pragya Thakur, it was also another MP, Nalin Katil, who made absolutely horrendous statements. Anil Soumitra has already been suspended from the party, the primary membership of the party. We'll try and talk about all these issues, about what kind of message the BJP is trying to give and why still hang on to these individuals who are considered either loose cannons or motor mouths. But that's in a bit. Before I introduce my panel on Newsnight tonight,
the party ne unko so-called notice issue karne ka nirnay kiya hai. Unka jawab aane ke baad डिसिप्लिनरी कमेटी इस पर निर्णय करेगी. हमारी पार्टी का संविधान है और इसके हिसाब से आगे कार्यवाही होगी.
नरेंद्र मोदी, मेरा तो आरोप है, नरेंद्र मोदी के दिल में भी यही भावना है, अमित शाह के मन में भी यही भावना है. वो कितना ही अब नाटक नौटंकी करें, ये विचारधारा से ही इस देश को सबसे बड़ा खतरा है. प्रज्ञा को, जिन्होंने ये बयान दिया है, उसको वो पार्टी से निष्कासित करेंगे? अली आंसू से काम नहीं चलेगा मोदी जी. अगर आप इसमें निंदा करते हैं तो चुनाव आयोग से मांग करिए कि इनकी वोट देने का अधिकार छीना जाए.
Hitesh Jain of the BJP joins us now along with Rajiv Desai as well as Sanjeev Srivastava. Thank you, gentlemen, for joining me on Newsnight. First to you, Sanjeev Srivastava, because I want a non-political or an apolitical look at what Sadhvi Pragya Thakur has said. First off, do you feel that there is a sort of mixed message coming in from the BJP? They seem to be caught between a rock and a hard place. Even though the Prime Minister says he would never forgive Pragya Thakur, the same day Amit Shah in that press conference says he does not and the party does not regret a candidature of such a person. I'm going to remind my viewers now, Sanjeev, before you answer that, what she had said. She had said Nathuram Godse was a Deshbhakt, is a Deshbhakt, and will remain a Deshbhakt. People calling him a terrorist should look within. Such people will be given a befitting reply in these elections. Now, as to the apology, Sanjeev, yesterday we got to know that she had apologized to the Madhya Pradesh BJP chief. It was not a public apology. What do you think the BJP is trying to convey here?
See, whatever the BJP may be trying to convey, a couple of things stand out. I think number one, Sadhvi Pragya has been a disaster for the BJP. The biggest mistake that the Modi-Amit Shah combination has done vis-a-vis 2019 election. They thought that they were being, for lack of a better phrase, too clever by half, that to put and box Digvijay Singh into a corner, somebody who talked of saffron terror or Hindu terror, let's bring out a face which symbolizes or epitomizes Hindutva. Instead, they brought in somebody who was accused of terror. So, entire country, a wrong message came. All those people who were supporting BJP for different reasons, a number of them actually felt let down and felt bad So that is number one. Number two, I went to Bhopal and I can tell you a lot of BJP supporters, BJP cadre, BJP sympathizers, people who haven't don't like Digvijay Singh for one reason or the other, have actually ended up voting for Digvijay Singh. Because there may be one thing in most constituencies that people are not voting for the BJP candidate for Modi. But in Bhopal, one could see that people had this feeling that after all, candidate matters. And what kind of a face will we show if we elect someone like Sadhvi? So the contest there is very bitter. And I think the best case scenario now for the BJP would be that Sadhvi Pragya loses the election.
Okay,
that's
now,
the easiest
now, Hitesh,
way out for
Hitesh
them.
Jai, I want
Otherwise,
to ask you.
Really, and if the election gets close.
Look, I want to ask you, Hitesh, very quickly, because this is exactly what Amit Shah said when asked about the press in the press conference about Sadhvi Pragya. He said, and I quote Mr. Shah now, Hitesh ji, "We don't regret her candidature. Her candidature is an answer to Congress's vote bank politics, etc., etc." He then says that disciplinary proceedings will be initiated and we'll go from there. Now, that was seen to be as a sort of evasive answer on the part of Mr. Shah. And it's not just Sadhvi Pragya, that's the problem. Because you have Anil Soumitra, who's been suspended, to be fair, from the BJP. There was Nalin Kateel as well, who made obnoxious statements about Mahatma Gandhi. Now, there are people today who say that till yesterday, you were sending your critics to Pakistan. Now there is a situation where people like Pragya Thakur, where people like Nalin Kateel, where people like Anil Soumitra are sending Bapu to Pakistan, and that's the line we have to draw. What exactly is the BJP doing about this?
Well, BJP has drawn a clear line, and there cannot be any abuse of Mahatma Gandhi. And the strong words have come from none other than the Prime Minister of the country and also from the party president. The party president very clearly has taken certain disciplinary measures and he has strongly condemned and he says that we do not approve such statements. Also, you have to look what has, since 2014, what was the first step taken by the Prime Minister from the ramparts of the Red Fort? He said in 2019, we will be celebrating 150 years of Mahatma Gandhi. And this is the time to give him a tribute. And the
Hitesh
tribute
ji,
will be...
I'm sorry, sir.
This Swachh Bharat Abhiyan came.
What exactly
Swachh
do you
Bharat
think
Abhiyan
people...
was a tribute to Mahatma
really,
Gandhi.
You really
and
believe,
therefore,
Hitesh,
when people make such
No, one second. Hitesh ji, allow me. Don't you think that's hypocritical, sir?
Do not find any place in the party.
Sir, don't you think that's hypocritical that on one hand you say the Prime Minister...
I don't think it is a hypocritical...
No, but let me ask you, sir. On one hand, you say the Prime Minister took inspiration for Swachh Bharat from Mahatma Gandhi. Okay, understood, accepted. On the other, you're giving tickets to people. Your MPs are making such statements about Mahatma Gandhi. Then you pawn them off saying that these are personal opinions, we'll act against them. But the damage has already been done. How did you expect people to believe that the BJP takes inspiration from Mahatma Gandhi and the rest when there are people within your party who get rewarded, who get candidatures, who are made MP chiefs or MP media cell chiefs, and then they try and run down Mahatma Gandhi, and then you say we'll initiate inquiries, but we do not regret the candidature of such people? Isn't that hypocritical, sir?
Well, I don't think it is hypocritical because we have seen motor mouth everywhere. I mean, the person, gentleman who you mentioned, he is from the media cell. But look at the language of Mamata Banerjee when she says that throw Prime Minister out of the country. You look at the personal comments by Mayawati. You look at the personal comments made by Rahul Gandhi.
But
I mean, like, for example, today he said
Narendra
he made
Modi,
a journalist.
You can't compare Mahatma Gandhi to Narendra Modi.
That he owns the journalist and
you,
he can send it to...
Sir, you can are you comparing Narendra Modi, the Prime Minister, to the father of the nation? I think that would be an unfair comparison. Because this is being said about Mahatma Gandhi, somebody who's been held dear by an entire nation. Not by one political party, not by one government, but the entire country.
Well, according to me, one should not make such kind of comments against any individual, whether he's a prime minister, whether he's a father of the nation, or even normal common man. One should not make such kind of comments. These comments do not find a place in the civil society. And such comments are condemnable against any individual.
But you won't take back a candidature. That's not something you would look into, the BJP.
Well, Well, we have said there are two parts. One is her candidature and one is her statement and other aspects. And we have said that she will be facing the disciplinary committee. That is the constitution and the discipline of the party. And let the disciplinary committee allow them to take the proper and appropriate decision.
All right.
And let's
Desai,
not be a judge over the disciplinary committee.
All right. Rajiv Desai, do you buy this at all?
No. Listen to the sleight of hand. He just ended up saying we can't abuse anybody, not even Narendra Modi, not even the father of the nation, not even the common man, as though they should all be equal. But the father of the nation is the Mahatma the world over. So that's one thing. But I think what is haunting the BJP is its fundamental problem, that the BJP's core vote bank is the Hindutva vote bank. Now, it's a limited vote bank. They have to reach out and try and get more people, which is what they did a little and got some seats in 2014. A lot of the ones that were attracted to him for development and all have fled. So they are back to their core. And in fact, they're even losing their core. So they brought in these kind of people. So I think they're very, very, very confused. They haven't been able to run a government for 5 years. They've done demonetization and all such rubbish. Their campaign has just completely crumbled into name calling and yelling and screaming and violence, as we saw in Calcutta. And now finally, this incredibly embarrassing press conference, which as a professional, I'd say it has done the BJP the most damage of all, because he's seen as the guy sitting next to the party president and being a puppet. So, you know, they have to try and resolve the difference. Are they a Hindutva party? They 5 years they haven't been able to build a Hindu nation. So they have to reconcile themselves. If they mature, they would become like in Europe. They could become a right wing sort of religious right party.
I think Hitesh wants to come in and
like the Christian Democrats.
Okay, Rajiv ji, I think Hitesh wants to counter you on that. Hitesh, very quickly before I go back to Sanjeev.
Well, frankly speaking, as far as Rajiv Desai is concerned, he is going to see all the fault. Sadhvi Pragya said, we condemned immediately, we have taken a disciplinary action, but we cannot expect the same thing from Congress. I mean, the kind of the discourse they lowered, he's talking about the violence in West Bengal. There was contested fight going on all over the country.
Excuse me.
In fact,
stop,
you saw TMC
Boone
killing the Congress workers.
No, I'm sorry.
And
Athar,
still he calls,
they cannot do
I mean,
this.
Still he blames us for the violence.
Congress.
I mean, this is the biggest joke.
I have nothing to do with the Congress. I support their agenda. That's
yes.
all.
All right. Okay. I want to take a very short break now. Gentlemen, give me a second. Give me a second, please. I have to take a very short break right now. When I come back, the political repercussions, if any at all, we'll try and discuss that on the second half of Newsnight. Please stay with us. We'll be right back. So the BJP says they've initiated inquiry proceedings, disciplinary action against those individuals who had maligned Mahatma Gandhi. And these are, of course, more than one in number. Pragya Thakur, Nalin Katil, as well as Anil Soumitra, along with Anant Kumar Hegde, who had made contentious statements, but then completely backtracked and claimed that his Twitter account was hacked. Now, how many people are buying that? I don't know. But the political repercussion, if any, Sanjeev Srivastav, you said this has hurt the BJP clearly. And there is still one more phase to go, around 59 seats, most of them, a lot of them actually in the Hindi heartland, where the BJP fancies its chances. Do you really believe that one particular comment where the BJP is not even going all out and condemning Pragya Thakur for this, even though they say they've initiated disciplinary inquiries, but not saying a word on her candidature, is it really going to harm the BJP at all? Is that why we saw the Prime Minister today coming out, making statements in these interviews, condemning Sadhvi Pragya, being in that press conference? Is this damage control?
See, to be fair, Athar, Prime Minister His track record has been so far not to come out with a statement very soon. And usually he doesn't condemn or react while there have been some other provocations immediately in terms of time, not very soon. He's not known to give a kind of a quick reaction, whether it's lynching, and he takes his own time about making the politically correct statement. But in this case, he has to be given credit. And I think also because somewhere his own prestige was on stake, because like you were saying earlier, that Bapu and Mahatma Gandhi and Sardar Patel are the two icons, Gujarati icons, which are somewhere close to Narendra Modi, maybe not on a personal level, but that I can't vouch for, but certainly on a political image making, on a pragmatic level, these are two icons who are very close to him, and he has constantly talked about them during the last 4.5 years. So he had to come down like a ton of bricks on Pragya Thakur. What amazed me in the evening, this evening, was that Amit Shah's reaction was kind of half-hearted. He said all the right things, but there was not the same kind of fire or not the same kind of energy or conviction in his answer, which the Prime Minister had. So there is some kind of, either there was a communication gap between the Mr. Amit Shah did not fully realize the gravitas of the Prime Minister's statement.
Is there a case to be made that the BJP is trying to write two votes at the same time?
And I will repeat, the best case scenario for BJP will be for Pragya Thakur to lose, so that they don't have to deal with this problem anymore.
But it's not just Pragya Thakur, is it? It's Anand Kumar Hegde, it's Nalin Kateel, who's also an MP. Hegde is a central minister. You have another person, Anil Soumitra, who made atrocious remarks. He was suspended. But it's not just Sadhvi Pragya Thakur, is it, Sanjeev? There are people in the BJP and its immediate area or whatever vicinity you want to call it, who do perhaps believe that Godse was a patriot. They keep coming out with that particular statement off and on, and this time it's politically inconvenient, yes, but how long will the BJP keep trying to ride two boats?
Yes. See, Athar, there are two things. There is that extreme right wing which supports Nathuram Godse and takes his action as justifiable for what they think was Mahatma Gandhi's leaning towards the Muslims. So there has always been that constituency. Even today, there have been a number of tweets by fairly respectable people who have actually said that at least Nathuram Godse stood his ground, faced the trial bravely, and testified as to why he did what he did. That's a separate thing. But to call him a Desh Bhakt hai, rahega aur tha, that is going a bit too far, because even while a little bit of defense for Godse can be condoned, there is a temple for Nathuram Godse, for God's sake, in this country. So, but to criticize Mahatma Gandhi and to describe Godse as a patriot Deshbhakt in the same breath was, I think, that was really crossing the Rubicon. And also, Pragya Thakur is, what you say, man of the moment or woman of the moment. So while Anand Hegde and others are not so much relevant in today's discourse, Pragya Thakur was for an entirely different set of reasons, because she was in the first place a terror accused. So ye to sone pe suhaga, karela upar se neem chada ho gaya. So that is the bigger problem.
Okay, now my last question to Mr. Hitesh Jain. It's not as if this is new, is it, Mr. Jain? The fact that Pragya Thakur or Nalin Kateel or Anil Soumitra or Anand Kumar Hegde, if you look in the past as well, Sakshi Maharaj, who's an now MP, currently sitting MP, in 2014 had said, and I quote him now, Godse was a nationalist, Gandhiji also did a lot for the nation. Atrocious statement, but he made that statement. The RSS mouthpiece in October 2014 had said, Godse was much better than Nehru. This is the RSS mouthpiece, December 2014. Ram Jet Malani, as far back when he was part of the BJP in 1981, had said that Godse and Gandhi shared the same vision. And that's not all, sir. I want to go back to 1970, where the RSS mouthpiece organization on Gandhiji had said, and I quote them, sir, it was in support of Nehru's pro-Pakistan stand that Gandhiji went on a fast, in the process turned the people's wrath on himself. I could quote many such instances, sir. So there is always an element very close to the BJP, the Janasangh or the RSS, whatever you want to call it, that does hold that belief. Do you really want people to buy this when you say that the Prime Minister will not forgive Pragya Thakur or Anant Kumar Hegde or whoever? Doesn't this come with an element of hypocrisy, if not hypocrisy outright?
Well, I don't think so. There are some odd cases that you have cited and we have condemned them, and we do not believe in the ideology or the kind of statements these people have made, and we have said in an unequivocal language what we condemn. Second, as Sanjeev was telling, for last four and a half years, or if you will look for 14 years of when Prime Minister was in Gujarat also, and if you look at his tenure also, all throughout, he used to speak about Mahatma Gandhi, he used to speak about Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel, he used to speak about how to bring their words into action and how to live their life, and not just on the paper or they should be the statue, but to ensure that we follow the principles, and those principles are put to things in the day-to-day life. Now, since you made on the right-wing statement, I also want you to remind one very important fact that one of the candidates of the Congress party in the state of Maharashtra for the Ratnagiri constituency was the member of Sanatan Sanstha, the same Sanatan Sanstha who speak about Godse. So it is not some, so I mean, like, there are cases of isolation that are happening. Sanatan Sanstha member was fielded by Congress as its candidate, and we all know what Sanatan Sanstha's view has been on Mahatma Gandhi.
All right,
also.
We have to end
so
there. We have to end there, sir. We have no more time on this. But thank you, Hitesh Jain, for coming out and fielding all the questions. Thank you for joining us. Rajiv Desai and Sanjeev Srivastava, thank you for joining us on Newsnight. Abhinathar Khan, thank you for watching.